Hello everyone, it's Martin's Shave Tests. Oh my goodness me, I'm late. It's 10 to 6 of a Friday evening on the 14th of June, and it's been a terrible day. Oh well, for weather it's been a terrible day, but then it is England, isn't it? So, after all. Anyway, I'm going to just try a little of this rather nice Kaizen. This is the Ariana and Evans Mad Bird on a Dragon special soap. It's the one which has a very nice sweet aroma. It rather smells of sweets. Anyway, today's shave test is going to be a little bit unusual. There's been a lot of talk, quite rightly, by us fellow YouTubers about the relative merits of synthetic edges versus natural edges. Now, my argument is that it depends so much on the steel. It's no good comparing a synthetic edge on a, say, a Japanese razor to a natural edge on, say, a Spanish or an English razor. I think there's too many variables. So, what we're going to do today is use two razors from the same company, from the same, roughly the same period. Very high quality German, and they're Pumas. One's a Puma 89. I think the other one's a Puma 90. Anyway, it's not important. What's important is I restored and honed them both. One having a fresh synthetic edge, which I used the other day, which was phenomenally sharp. Possibly that's its detriment. That's the only trouble with synthetic. If you go to 20K synthetic edges, you're going to get a really, really, really blisteringly laser sharp, effortless shave. But it does leave you just a little tiny bit tender afterwards. So, my argument has been, I've got a very nice quality natural edge on a coticule on another Puma. And it's one I've used several times, and it's not in rotation very much, but it's a very, very, very nice quality edge. And I thought, why not go Puma to Puma? Synthetic edge versus natural edge, and see the results. I've also dug something very special out. So if anyway, first let's do the test and see what happens. That's a fair enough lather. Nice pong on this Ariana and Evans. It smells of sweet shops. Anyway, be that as it may. Okay, dry the fingers. Also, tiny little bit of instruction from me. For those who are endeavouring to start on the wonderful field of straight razor shaving, it always pays, chaps, to have dry fingers, to approach the face gently, and to use the spine. That's the spine, the back of the blade. Put the spine on first. That'll judge roughly where your edge will be. Then tilt it down very slowly until, oh look, it just starts to cut. Downstrokes only, nice, short, gentle downstrokes with the grain of the beard. Not against the grain until you're a little bit more advanced. And as you can see, it does a very, very, very nice job. The trick is don't get overconfident. You're trying to build one thing only, muscle memory. If you build your muscle memory up, everything's just simple. Oh, it's nice, nice, nice blade this. This is a 20K edge, but very, very sharp. Oh, deep hollow blade, the same as the next one I'm going to use. Push your tongue into your cheek to push out the bristle. Keep your angles low. After a few attempts, you'll build the muscle memory. Yes, you're going to get a few little dings. You'll get a couple of little cuts maybe, but so what? Anyway, as you can see, That's very nice. So that I will only know after the shave whether or not there's any slight residual abrasions. So this is the Puma 89, which I used the other day. It's still got its original Italian label on it. This was made for the Italian market, ended up in Scotland, came down to me. I've restored it, I've honed it, and it's as good as new. This will last another 100 years. Anyway, another thing, I bought a whole case of these packing peanuts. These are little white biodegradable ones. And yes, they're rubbish. They really are. They're truly awful because they vary in density. Now that went in like it wasn't there. You see? The other parts of this packing peanut is a resistance. So I think we have a very slight difference in surface feel, which is not going to be very reliable. So packing peanut, very sharp razor, pressure test. Now then, look at that. There it's resisting just a little bit. And there it's going straight in like it's not made of anything. So I would say I've got now another packing case of the S-shaped green ones on the way. So hopefully they will do better. This is unreliable. And to prove it, here's a different make. These are little shiny coated ones. They are completely resistant to being cut. Absolutely bulletproof and useless. And here is expanded polystyrene. And of course, yeah, right, the blade sinks in, but so what? So I would say, for me, I still stick with the classic baby tomato. However, that's another day. Let's go now onto a little bit more lava. Do a dapper shaves. Make sure you've got plenty of moisture. I think the Ariana and Evans is not the worst one for drying out, but we are technically in summer now. So I'm going to put a little bit more of the Ariana and Evans on. And enjoy the smell of humbugs. There you go. That'll do. Okie dokie. Dry the fingers. Now we're going to go onto the natural edge. This is a coticule. And this one I restored. And this is a beautiful little razor. This is a Puma 91. It's an early one. It's Latajum and Soon, or Soon, obviously German. And yeah, this has got rather attractive translucent scales. Very nice. But this one is different. This is on a coticule. And the hanging hair test is supreme on both of them. So let's see. Again, being very careful to start. Yeah. And then get into it. Yeah, I would say a very slight difference. Very, very slightly, feels very slightly blunt in comparison to the over-sharp 20K. But I might be wrong. Yeah, they're both superb. Nice. I'm using these as the most popular, pretty much the most popular of the straight razor sizes. These are both about 1/6. I think this 91 might be slightly less. Yeah, very nice feel. Excuse the pun. I'd be spitting hairs to say which is the better. What counts in this test, which is what Martin's shave test is all about, what counts now is going to be the after feel. So this side of my face, I'm going to stay with synthetic. And this side, I'm going to stay with coticule and see what happens. Yeah, very, very nice feel, this coticule. But through my limited testing, I would say one of the problems is the steel, as we've just touched on. At least both these steels are restored German, probably 1935 to probably the 89s, 1955, but in that period. So they're both classics. And I would say, without going into a further test, both are very, very good. Now we'll do one more little test. Lather up again. We're going to go against the grain. And we're going to use exactly as before. This side is going to be synthetic. And this side is going to be natural. Right. So, there's the Puma 89 in all its glory, which has the very nice etching, Puma Special, still on it. So we'll go across the grain, both on the moustache and on the face. Hope all our fellow friends shavers are good today. I had a chat with a couple, lovely, lovely fellas. Yeah, that's really good. I'm being slow and cautious today because I'm trying to gauge the feel. Yeah, very, very nice. Against the grain isn't difficult. It's not for beginners. It's only very quickly pick up. But obviously with the grain of the hair is easier. As I'm doing now, that's with the grain. Turn it round, buffing pass. Can't hardly see what I'm doing. I've got a lot of sunlight coming in. How rare is that in England, sunlight? Yeah, that thing, I'm holding this as well as I might as well. Some razors hold better than others. Anyway, that's that one done. That's the second pass. That's one side of my face. Let's now go and do the other side very quickly. It's disgusting stuff. Why anybody would want a beard? Ugh. I remember my parents there, my grandparents, they always used to say, never trust a man with a beard. Now this is the 91 Puma. This is on the natural edge. You know what? It does feel good. Very slightly smaller blade. This is probably about the best for learning. It's just under a 6/8. Use confidence. You can do a fool's pass single-handed, which is so what, but you know, let's do it. Yeah, that's lovely. A bit hesitancy. That's all right. It makes any difference two-handed. Not a lot. Because I've already shaved it. Anyway, give my eccentricities. So there you have it. Yeah, they both feel absolutely great. Feel wise, too early to say. I would still give it very slightly to this, my old friend, the 91, which is about its sixth or eighth shave. It doesn't probably ever need replenishing, rehoning, refreshing even. Very nice razor. However, I just wanted to show a bit of a special today, before I call it a wrap. Of course, we're at the magic 15 minutes, and after that becomes boring. I'm sorry, chaps. So let's just give a final pass. Just a final pass. I'm going to show you something a bit lovely. It's a coincidence, but a good friend of mine, Marcel, he just showed me something which he's already unfortunately sold. He had a late round nose Palmer, and the Spanish Palmer is as good any day. In fact, some claim better than the Philharmonica, the famous Philharmonicas. And lo and behold, I'm an identical one. Same blade shape, same address, same white scales. Difference is, when I got mine, when I got it off eBay, I've got it in England off eBay. It wasn't ferociously expensive. I had to do it up just a tiny bit, but it came with its original papers and its original guarantee tag, which is like, oh my God. So, there's the original box with the Calidad Extra Largo and the number 14 7/8 with the beautiful little palm tree, because it is a Palmera. There is the actual razor. There's the guarantee card. And there's the little metal thing, the little Palmera Extra, which hangs very delicately off the razor when it was new. So this one has obviously had virtually no use at all. And look at the size of it. Now that is a true 14. There's a Palmera 14 with the little palm tree and Fabricación Española. And of course it's by Von Volmer. Juan Volmer S.A. So Spain. And these are one of the great kings of the razor world. So, yeah, it feels lovely too. This is just to get the last vestiges. This is a noisy breed. Oh, this is a noisy razor. I was going to say noisy beast. It's not an animal. Oh yes, that's superb. I remember that this one, I haven't used it for about a year and a half. And this is also on a synthetic edge. 20K. Very gentle. Better quality steel than Puma. I think most people would agree the Palmeras are, you know, really Lamborghinis, Rolls Royces. That's lovely. Just trimming. Yeah, all these views of mine are subjective. Nah, the winner today, definitely the Palmera. But for a cheaper alternative, there's still quite a few Pumas out there. And they're very nice quality German steel. But I don't think you can honestly go any better than a good Palmera. Anyway, chaps, I don't want to take any more time up. This is nearly 19 minutes, 44 seconds. Just a little call out to everyone. Thank you so much, guys, for supporting my channel. I've just gone over 500 subscribers. 500 subscribers, yes. So If you want to see more exciting and interesting razors and what I can do with them, do subscribe, do send me a like, and I will see you guys very shortly. I'm just going to wash this off. We've just hit the 20 minutes. I'm sorry to be boring. Oh, so comfortable. To think there's people out there that actually use double-edged razors. Oh, bless them. Anyway, that is absolutely wonderful. I'll give it the triple salt test. No, nothing at all. And that's with three different razors on three slightly different steels. And the result is the slightest tingle, because I've been over it three times in three different blades. Luxury. A little bit of a splash going on now, chaps. I'm going to be a tiny bit longer while I put on some of this rather nice Mad Bird on Dragon splash. So we'll see what that goes on like. Skin food. Oh, it does smell nice. It's sweet and citrus. So it's a little bit of the previous soap's sweet shop smell, but definitely a bit of citrus. I like this. I should use this more often, especially as my beloved in Morocco, I hope to see again very soon. Just to call out to Alda, if she ever watches any of this, and to say, I shall be with you soon. It was Marrakesh last time. Who knows where next time? Anyway, chaps, thanks so much. Over 500, can't believe it. And I'll see you all very soon. Bye for now.